Hello and welcome to this lesson about scientific notation. The learning target for this video is being able to write it and completing operations with numbers in scientific notation form. So first, before I even get to anything about what scientific notation is, let's start off with some hopefully easy math for you. What is 35 times 10? Hopefully, you know that when you're multiplying by 10, you just take your decimal point and you bump it over one spot, and what you end up getting is 350. And then likewise, what is 15 times 100? Well, again, this time you'll move it two spots and go, oops, get one or 1500, adding two zeros to get 1500. Now let's kick it up a notch. What is 300 divided by 10? Hopefully you know the rule with dividing by tens is you just move your decimal one spot to the left. And if that's, with that being the case, you'll end up getting 30. And let's go one step further. What is 25 divided by 10? Here, you'd still move over. The only difference is now you won't have a whole number. You will have a fraction, or sorry, a fraction, a decimal, 2.5. And so there are these rules about multiplying or dividing by something with a power of 10. So that could be 10, it could be 100, it could be a million, it could be any number with a bunch of zeros after it. Any number with one and a bunch of zeros after it. Where you just move the decimal that many spots to the left or the right, depending if you're multiplying or dividing. Well, that's kind of what's happening with scientific notation. Scientific notation is a means of writing a really big number or really small number in a concise way. So we're going to take a number that might be in the millions, might be in the billions, or it might also be in the thousandths, where there's going to be a lot of zeros, or there's going to be a decimal point with a lot of zeros before you actually have any real numbers in there. And so scientific notation is all about taking that number and writing it in a really concise way. And the way it works is it's always going to kind of follow this format. A point, or A point BC times 10 to the D. Now I'm just using the first four letters of the alphabet to kind of make a point here. You're going to write your number in scientific notation as a decimal times some power of 10. Okay? And the one rule is that A has to be between 1 and 9. And it could include 1 or 9, but it has to be between 1 and 9. So you cannot have a two-digit number. It has to be a single-digit number in A. Alright? And so, let's say we had something like 12,500. And we want to write this in scientific notation. Well, what we'll do is we'll just take this first number right here, that 1, and we're going to put that into the A spot. So we'll have 1, decimal point, all the other stuff that's significant, that matters. In that case, all these non-zero numbers, 0.25. And then we're going to go times 10. And here's where we get to use that decimal counting trick. How many times did I have to move the decimal? 1, 2, 3, 4. So the decimal's originally here. It's now between the 1 and the 2. And that moved it 4 times. And so that's going to become 1.25 times 10 to the 4th. And that's how you write numbers in scientific notation. And so we're taking a larger number and writing it in a more concise way. And the same works if we're dealing with small numbers. So let's consider 0.0063. So with this, we want to just focus on the 6 and the 3. 6 will become my A. So that's going to go in that A spot, 6, and then 0.3. I'm going to be timesing it by some power of 10. Now here's the trick. I'm going to make a small number a slightly larger number. And I'm moving my decimal to another direction here. So I'm moving to the right instead of moving to the left. I need to subtract my exponent. And so I'm going over 1, 2, 3 spots. That's 10 to the third, but instead of saying third, I'm going to say negative 3. And so there's a couple ways you can look at this. One is that if you have a large number, I think it's probably the easiest way to look at it, is so a large number is going to correspond to a positive exponent. And small numbers, and I'm talking about small, I mean something that's less than one, so less than one, is going to have a negative exponent. So let me do a couple more examples of writing some numbers. Or let's actually work the other way around. Let's say we had something like 3.32 times 10 to the fifth. Well, here I'm using that trick I used at the very beginning of the video where, you know, I'm timesing something by 10, but I'm doing it five times. So I'll take my number 3.32. I know the decimal's here, and I'm going to move it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 spots. And I'll just fill in all those blank spots with zeros. And so I have the number 300, and so let me rewrite that, 332,000. That's what it became. Let's say I had something like 8.54 times 10 to the negative 7. Here, now, one thing I have to look at is, I have a negative number, so that means I'm going to have a really small decimal. So I'm going to write my 854 way over here to the right, knowing that I got to bump this spot, or this decimal here, seven times to the left. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then I'll put a seventh zero right there. Another little trick here is that whatever this number is, you write that many zeros. And you put a decimal after the first one. That's a little hack right there for you. So again, that's writing numbers in scientific notation. Now let's talk about adding and subtracting them. Think about this. What would you do if you had 1,300 plus 2,300? You would just add them like this. You'd go, you know, 6, a bunch of zeros here, 3, 3,600. Well, let's convert these into scientific notation. This would be 1.3 times 10 to the 1, 2, 3. And this would be 2.3 times 10 to the third power. When it comes to adding and subtracting, the big thing is you have to have the same exponent. So make sure you have the same exponent. So have to have same exponent. After that, you just add or subtract the numbers. So going back up to this example right here, add or subtract, I will get 3.6 times, and you're going to keep the decimal or the 10, the power of 10 to the same. So 3.6 times 10 to the third, and guess what? If I bumped over this three times, I'd have 3,600, which is the same thing I had there when it wasn't in scientific notation. And so the point of this is to be able to do something in scientific notation exclusively. Because as these numbers get larger, and you're talking about, you know, to the ninth power, the 12th power, the 15th power, you don't want to write all that out. You want to keep it simple. So that's what you do. First, make sure you have the same exponent. Then you add or subtract the numbers. Simple enough. Let's talk about multiplying and dividing. For multiplying and dividing, it's a little more complicated. Okay, what you're going to do, well, actually, it might be more complicated, but at the same time, it might be easier. So let's get some numbers down here. Let's say we have 2.1 times 10 to the fifth, and we're going to multiply this by 3 times 10 to the eighth. So the trick with multiplying is to use the associative property and the commutative property to regroup some things. And what you do is you can be like, all right, I'm going to swap these two guys. And so then I end up getting 2.1 times 3, and I'll group those together, times 10.5 times 10 to the 8th, or 10 to the 5th times 10 to the 8th, and I group those together. And then here, I just focus on this, 2.1 times 3. Well, that will give me 6.3. And here, I can use rules of exponents to get times 10 to the 13th, because I'm going to go 10 to the 5 plus 8. And that's actually it. That is all you do. And so you're going to, when it comes to multiplying and dividing, let's write out the rules. You are going to multiply or divide the numbers out. And then two, you use rules of exponents on the tens. So let me do one more example. Let's say we had 4.2 times 10 to the 7th divided by 2 times 10 to the 3rd. So what I'm going to do is divide my numbers out. So another way we can think about this is maybe writing it as a fraction. 4.2 times 10 to the 7th and then 2 times 10 to the 3rd. And when I think of it as like a fraction, I can see maybe a little bit better, these numbers can get divided, and here there'll be some rules of exponents. And so I might do a little scratch work. 4.2 divided by 2 is going to be 2.1. So it's going to be 2.1 times. And now based off of rules of exponents, what I'm going to do here is do 10 to the 7th minus 10 to, oh, no, sorry. 10 to the 7 minus 3. Subtract those exponents. And when I do that, I'll get times 10 to the 4th. And there we go. So that's how you write something in scientific notation. That's how you add something in scientific notation. And that's how you multiply or add and subtract. And how you multiply and divide stuff in scientific notation. Now, there are a few other subtle nuances that this video did not go over. We can talk about those another time, but this lays down the foundation you need to at least start to be successful with scientific notation. Good luck with your homework and practice, and let me know if you have any questions.